In today's episode, we're going to be taking a quick look at a fragrance by the company Kieran NYC. This is their most recent installment, and it's called Rose Ink. So make sure to stay tuned. Now, before we begin our fragrance review of Rose Ink by Kieran NYC, I do want to mention that if you are a fan of fragrance-related content, if you like fragrance reviews here on YouTube, but also top lists, giveaways, unboxings, and pretty much anything having to do with fragrances, please do consider supporting this channel by subscribing to it. All you have to do is click on that red button in the corner. And of course, while you're at it, also please be sure to enable notifications by clicking on the bell. This way, whenever we do put out these videos, they will get delivered straight to your feed. So, how's it going, Carlos?
Pretty good. Thank you.
Thank you for joining me again today.
My pleasure.
And I just want to remind the folks at home that there is going to be a giveaway for an official travel atomizer from the brand for this fragrance. All you have to do to enter this 0.33 ml giveaway, or 1 ounce, is just leave a comment down below and let me know which of the Kieran NYC fragrances sounds the most appealing to you. Is it Santal Sky? Is it, what are some of their other ones? I'm forgetting at the moment.
10 a.m. Flirt.
Oh yeah, that's right, Sunday Brunch. These are all really good fragrances. And so just, I'm gonna leave the information to where you can access the website down below in the description section. Check it out, come back here and let me know which one sounds like your favorite. So, you're the guest of honor today. I would like to hear your thoughts.
Well, it's definitely a rose fragrance. The rose is prominent. It's spicy.
Yeah.
It's a little leathery from the saffron. It's not a jammy rose. It's a little bit of a brighter and spicy rose. And then the dry down is like musky.
I get that too. There's a lot of rose going on in here. So as the namesake of the fragrance would convey, you must expect rose from this one, right? You have to be a fan of the floral ingredient. But you do have that nice accent of saffron in there. So it is a rose on the spicier side. And if you're familiar with the direction that saffron can go in many other fragrances, it kind of adds like this leathery nuance.
Yes, for
to
sure.
This fragrance.
Absolutely.
So, I mean, it's almost like a very sort of sensual and erotic kind of a rose if you think of leather and rose, right? So the saffron, it is spicy, but it's not spicy in an overly culinary way. It doesn't smell like a spice kitchen or a pantry or something like that. But I like that you said musky because it's something that didn't occur to me before. And the way that I've encountered cassis in the past, it also has a tendency of being a little bit musky as well. Now, what I like about this is that the note breakdown is written on the side of the box. I should also mention that the perfumer for this fragrance is Jerome Epinette, who has done many fragrances for Atelier Cologne, but also Byredo, even Zara. He's a very accomplished perfumer. Yeah, and he's great. We both met him in person several times. And this one, the vibe that it gives off is dark, warm, and wild. And the notes are saffron, cassis, damask rose, cedarwood, and crisp amber. Do you get a lot of woods from this fragrance or any ambery nuances?
Amber in the sense that it's maybe a little warm. Mm-hmm. Wearing on skin, it's sensual, as you said, and but it's not overly ambery or vanilla. There's nothing really sweet here.
Yeah.
And it's under $100.
Yeah.
Niche quality under $100.
100% niche quality. I mean, the same quality that you can expect from brands like Atelier Cologne and Byredo because it's the same exact perfumer, so they're working with the same factory. But it's awesome. If you're a fan of rose, I have a really good feeling you're gonna enjoy this one. Of course, like Carlos said, it's not a jammy rose. There are many different varieties of rose on the market. If you're looking for like a spicy rose, of course, you have Rose 31 by Le Labo. If you're looking for a very clean, smooth, yet slightly incensey rose, you have Lyric Man by Amouage. If you're looking for a really full, luscious rose, you have Frederick Malle, right? What is it? Portrait of a Lady is amazing. Porpora by Tiziana Terenzi is another great one. But this one is musky, it's smooth, it's a little ambery, not overly sweet, and leathery.
And did you know that he has the whole entire Fragrantica library in his head? Did you know that?
Well,
it's
no.
True.
It's all right. You know what it is? You just get so accustomed to talking about certain fragrances over and over.
Yeah.
And there are certain benchmark fragrances out there. So it's like when you think of plum, maybe you think of Andy Warhol. When you think of rose, you think of Portrait of a Lady, Sandalwood Santal 33. So it's like when you think of like a leathery rose, right? This is the first one that's gonna come to my mind now, which I think Karen NYC, they did a fantastic job. Once again, I'm going to leave all the information down below. And if you are interested in winning this thing, a 1 ounce travel atomizer official from the brand with the nice packaging, please go ahead and leave a like on this video. Also, subscribe to this channel if you're new to this channel and you took something of value from it. Also, please be sure to subscribe to Carlos's channel as well. His information is going to be down below. And again, the only thing you need to do is just leave a comment down below and let me know which Karen NYC fragrance seems the most interesting to you based off of the narratives on the website, but also the note breakdowns. Thanks again for watching. We love you guys. We'll see you next time.
Bye.
Bye.